This summer, Federal Express is testing a new prototype personal delivery vehicle known as Roxo. It was created to make autonomous last-minute deliveries and may be the way of the future.
You think about kind of the explosion here over the last few years of e-commerce. Everybody's buying everything online now, so we need to help support that growth.
Roxo weighs about 450 pounds, is about 5.5 feet tall, and has the capability to hold packages around 100 pounds. It is also designed to travel on local sidewalks or streets. It's that operation on local sidewalks and streets that had the Roxo operators make contact with the city to give a heads up on its operation as they continue to test how to make it work in a real-world environment.
It's a test and learn cycle, so we take everything that we learn there, bring it back into the labs, we change the software, we change the experience, we adjust it, we tweak it, and then we'll take that, do our simulation testing on it, kind of work through that, take it through all the paces to make sure safety is number one priority for us, so we're taking it through all the paces in our labs and simulation, and then we'll get ready for additional testing next year.
Roxo was developed for Federal Express by DECA 3 years ago. The company has been testing the robot in Manchester, New Hampshire, as well as various cities here in North Texas, including Richardson.
It's got the ability to detect things as far as 150 feet out, so it recognizes when things are moving towards it. It's got both long-range sensors to know when things are coming, and then it's got short-range sensors so that if something like a pet or something walked right in front of it, it would have the ability to sense that and stop.
Richardson police, fire, and city traffic engineers were all involved as developers prepared for testing here. They focused their mock deliveries in neighborhoods near Berkner High School, which gave them a good location to gather field research on its abilities.
And there's really kind of three primary areas that we're looking to learn from the test. One is see how does it work with the retailers in there and how does it fit within their ecosystem. We want to understand the societal impact. So when it's driving down the road, what are the reactions from people driving by or walking by and understanding that. And then third for us, it's learning about the autonomy itself, how well it performs, and making sure that we're continually kind of fine-tuning that experience and what it looks like.
Testing started in August and will continue later this year, but no word yet on when or if a Roxo robot is scheduled to start regular service in a neighborhood near you. Thank you for watching Richardson Today, keeping you connected.